Hello guys, this is Virendra Singh and welcome back at MasterCAM MIL 3D Tutorials and Toolpaths. MasterCAM for MIL 3D, this is our second tutorial. And in this tutorial, we will discuss about that how we can prepare that one part or a model by the help of surface commands. And after that, we discuss about how we can manufacturing that one part by the help of different type of toolpath of MasterCAM MIL 3D. So first, let me show in this part that how you can prepare that one model by the help of some surface commands. So in this video, you will learn different type of surface command. So in this video, you learn different type of surface command like as the flat boundary, draft, revolve, net. So you will learn all these command in this video. So first, let me start. So before starting, let me show you drawing. So that one is a drawing for that one part. This is a very simple and easy drawing. So let me show you before first. Let me understand you that what the drawing says. The full size of that one part is 210 by 150 mm. So full length is 210 and here is the 150 mm. So as you can hear, there is a one flower and all dimensions are here available. So first what I have to do, first I will create that one 2D part area and then I will modify or and by the help of surface commands I will create model like that one. So first I just create that one a 2D part area like that. So all dimensions are available here. So if you want to download the drawing link is also available in the description, or you can also make a screenshot. So let me start the drawing. So first for creating a drawing, we have to go in a wireframe and select a rectangle. After selecting a rectangle, click here and make a rectangle. What is the size of that one? Outer size, this is 210 and the length is -150 mm. And now press OK. Now the next, what is the next one process? We select a line, click here center, and we join here center to center. Now the next one process is we have to go in offset, click here and click here. What is distance for that one? The first distance is 28 mm. Okay, again click here, click here. What is the distance of that is as per the drawing? 43 mm. Okay, again click here, click here. What is the distance of that one? It is according to me 168 mm. Okay, again click here, here, and the next one distance is 182 mm. So I just created fully as per dimensions of the drawing. So now what I have to do, I have to create again by the help of few command, few lines. Again I have to go in offset, click this one line, click upper side. So what is the dimension? It's 130 divided by 2. Where is the 130? It is a dimension in a vertical form. And now press OK. Again, what I have to do? Again, I have to go in offset, click here and click here. What is the distance? It is 39 mm divided by 2. OK. So according, as you can see here, over most of the lines for the required for creating that one profile, we are done. Now what we have to do, I have to select arc 3 point, first point here, second point here middle, and third point here, and press OK. So as you can see, I just create that one profile area, and now I have to remove all unwanted lines. For removing all unwanted lines, you can see over I just deleted all unwanted line, and now what I have to do, I just have to create a flower part area. So where is my flower part area? Flower part area is like at here. So for creating a flower part area, what I have to do, I just have to again make some lines. For creating again line, I have to go in offset command, click center line, click upper side. What is the distance? Here distance is 20 mm, so I just input directly 10 mm. Okay, So again, I have to go for a creating horizontal line. Again, I have to go in offset. Click here. Click here. What is the distance? According to as per drawing, the distance is first is 85 mm. Again, click here. Click here. And the second one distance is 125 mm. Click. Okay. So again, what I have to do? Again, I have to go in arc 3 point. Click here. Click here. Click here. Okay. And now I can just remove all unwanted lines, which are all these three lines. So I just create a flower part, only one portion. So for creating whole portion, what I have to do? I have to mirror that one. So for mirror, I just click here and go in a mirror. Where I have to mirror? Vector. Select that one line. Okay. So as you can see, over first part or over first area of flower, that is done. So what I have to do now? I have to rotate according to angle of the drawing. First is 20 degree. Here, first is 20 degree, second 45 degree, and third one is 70 degree. For rotating that one, let me show you that how we can rotate. So for rotating, I just select both of these, click at the rotate, and what I have to do? I have to select rotating center point. So click here. What is the rotating center point? That one. So now click here and rotate that one. First, what is the angle? 20 degree. Click here, okay. Again, I have to select that. Select. What is the rotating angle? It's 45 degree. Again, I have to select. What is the rotating angle? It's 70 degree. Okay. So as you can see, I just created as per the drawing, so all unwanted lines. For deleting all unwanted lines, what I have to do? I just go at a divide. So first line which I want to delete, that one is this, this, and this. Again, as per drawing, that. So go on, again as per drawing, that. So guys, as you can see here, my flower one part is already I just prepared as per the drawing. So now what I have to do? Again, I have to create the second one portion of this, that flower. So for creating a second one portion of that one flower, I just have to select full that one, go for a mirror and vector and select that line. Okay, right click, clear color. So as you can see here, my flower part is done. So now what I have to do? It's very simple. I just have to divide all these lines. For why we are dividing all these lines, I will explain you in the future. So for dividing all these lines, I just click here, divide and break. Break this one line, break, 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 break. Make sure when you are preparing that one part model, so all flower lines should be in a break condition. So now what I have to do? I just have to create a new level of that flower. So let me show you that how you can create that flower in a new level. Select this flower, right click, new level. Make a number of level, and here we can input flower. Okay. So now there are both of two different level. First one is revolve surface. So guys, as you can see here, I just prepared that 2D part for that one, creating that one model by the help of surface command. What I have to do? I just have to revolve that one area for creating that type of area. So for revolving, before revolving that one command, so what I have to do? I just wash the drawing properly and etch per the drawing. Here is the radius value. What is the radius value? Is R1.5 here, R1.5 here. That's here, 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 and here. So what I have to do? I just create that one radius value in just 2D form. So for creating that one radius value in a 2D drawing, I just have to go in a master cam. Go for a wireframe slit. What is the size of slit radius? It's 1.5. Okay. So now, as you can see here, there is a very easy and simple method to be creating radius for that one area. So now, what I have to do next? I have to revolve that one. So for revolving that one, I have to go in a surface and click on a revolve tab. After selecting a revolve tab, I just have to select that entity which I want to revolve. Now here, okay, and select a center line along that revolve will be done. So now as you can see, our whole part is revolved. But what I have to do, I just have to revolve only half portion. So I just revolve half portion, but I want the revolve portion is upper side. So I can just change the direction by clicking here and press OK. So now as you can see here, I just revolve that one part. And as you can see, our first work is done, that I just make a surface command area by the help of revolve command. So now the next one thing what I have to do, I just have to create that flower of that one upper side area. So for creating a flower of the upper side area, there is some critical type work. So watch carefully. So for creating a flower of the upper side area, I just have to mark here. I just have to create that flower portion at the upper side area of that one surface. For creating that flower at the upper side of the surface portion, I just have to create a new level command here. Now I have to select all these flowers. For creating a one click, I just click here, select all flower, go in a project, go at here, select surface or solid, select that surface and make end selection, and now okay. So now as you can see here, my all flowers are done at the upper side area. And now what I have to do, I just make in a 2D form or in a wireframe form. Now I have to create that surface and create a flower portion like I already done in this. So that one is sometime critical type work, so watch carefully for learning that one. So for creating a vertical flower for this one area, what I have to do, I already make that one flower for the upper side portion. I just hide all unwanted required entities. So for go in a draft. So first, what I have to do, I just make the upper portion of this one. Just select. Click here, okay. What is the length of that one area? The total length is 3.0. How I just find that one? This is as per drawing. This first is 3.0, second one is 2.0, and third one is 1.0. So I just have to follow as per the drawing. So first I just do that one is 3.0. Then second one is create that 2.0. So which one lines I have to select for a 2.0? I just have to select, go for again surface, click at draft. This, that, click, okay. So total length is 2.0 as per the drawing. So now next one, again I have to go for draft, click all these lines which where I have to create. Be sure and select carefully and follow the same process. What is the length is 1.0. Press OK. So now as you can see here, I just create a vertical walls of these flowers. So now the next one thing what I have to do, I just have to create upper portion by the help of net command. So that flower can be, you know, upper side is closed. So for creating that one, what I have to require, I just require 2D entities or a line entity. For creating line entity, I just have to in a wireframe select all edges. So for curve all edges. Select all area, click here, and okay. So as you can see here at the all edges of that one flowers, there is a one line entity is done. So now what I have to do, I just have to remove all unwanted line entities by the help of Home tab, Duplicate, click OK. So now all the unwanted or duplicates line commands are now deleted. Now the next one process what I have to do? The next one process I have to do that I just have to create net commands by the help of command. I just have to select one net command. First, second, third line. Okay. As you can see here, that is a very easy and simple. Again, click, click, click. This is so easy to be created. Click, 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 click. By follow that same easy method process, easy process, you can easily create. I can also create that one surface command, that one area by the help of mirror command also. I just create that one net, I just create that one net. If I want to create net at the that one portion and that one portion, so I can also use a mirror command. So let me show you that how I can done by the help of a mirror command. So for creating by the help of mirror command, select that surface, click on mirror, select a vector. Where is my vector? That is so as you can see here, that is done here to here. Again for the again I have to create for that one area, select that surface, and it's easy and a simple method to be created. So as you can see here, I just create surface for that one area, that one area, that one area, that one area, and that one. But when we are creating a surface for that one portion, it is very critical to be created. So for creating that one, so guys, the next one process what I have to follow, that I have to create that upper portion by the help of net command. That is difficult compared to creating that one any other portion. So for creating that one, I just have to select that one line, select, 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 and press Alt E. Alt E means the all portion is hide and hide. It is used for the hide and unhide purpose. So for creating that one portion here, I just go have to net, select that line, select partial, click here, go in a line. Click here, change direction, click here, change direction, and press OK. So that one is the process which you have to follow. Otherwise, if you are creating in a normal portion, so MasterCam does not accept, because for creating a net command, we have to require minimum 3 lines. So make sure that you have to follow that one. So as you can see here, I just create in easy and by the help of easy and simple method, that upper portion is also. So all are done. Now the next one process what I have to do, as per the drawing, let me show drawing, that as per the drawing, the next one thing what I have to do, I just have to create that the bottom portion by the help of flat boundary in a surface command. So before creating a flat boundary of at the creating a flat boundary at the bottom side, bottom portion, what I have to do, I just have to go in a surface tab, click at flat boundary, click on here. That one is the portion which we are done in the starting of that one video. So there is a very, by the help, it's a really easy method to create that flat portion. So the next one process which what I have to do, I just want to create that one flat portion, make upper side, it's a 12 mm distance as per the drawing. So as you can see here, what is the total distance from here to here? It's 67 mm, but that one portion is upper side. It's a 55 mm. So when we are calculating, so that distance is 12 mm. So I just have to click here, go in a translate, 12, and move it. Okay. Clear color. So the next one process which I have to do, I just have to remove that portion or that surface. So for removing that surface, I just have to using one of the most valuable command of surface tab, which is known as trim to surface. So I just click trim to surface. First click that one surface, end selection. And then second one surface is end selection. Now I just have to click here and select split model. Again, so as you can see, when we are selecting a split model, it means surface is divided into two parts, but that surface is splitted also from the corners where surface is joined to each other. I just have to delete that one. And I also have to delete that one. It's a really hard to be work with a surface because there is a very small portion. Delete. So I wish, as you can see here, over my whole part is done as per the required of the drawing. So I wish you understand the whole process, what I have to do. I using a lot of commands of the surface tab. I using a lot of commands for the wireframe tab. In our next video, I will show you how we can machining first roughing and after that the finishing operation of MasterCAM Mill 3D. Be connecting and updated for more videos. Thank you.